Welcome. So glad that you could join us on this daily devotional. And this week we are going to look at revival. We're going to look at personal and corporate revival. And I really hope that it'll be a blessing to each and every one of us. We are excited about the things that bless our hearts. We're excited about certain things. We're excited about certain people, certain activities. But, you know, never once do we find it okay to lose our excitement, you know, about these wonderful things in our lives. You know, if it is a game that we're going to, we tend to be excited about it. Today, I don't want to talk about just our emotions of being excited, but in our relationship with God, spiritually, if we come to a place where we are dull, you know, that is really something that we must look into. Talking about David, you know, in many of his Psalms, he expresses his passion for God, his excitement for God. In one verse from Psalm 42, verse 1, it reads, "As the deer pants for the water brooks, so pants my soul for you, O God." And another scripture, very familiar one from Psalm 27, verse 4, he says, "One thing I have desired of the Lord, that will I seek, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord and to inquire in his temple." So David is expressing his desire and his passion for God. And we see there that he's really wanting a vibrant, passionate, dynamic and a deep relationship with God, one that transforms us inside out. And in our journey with the Lord, you know, if we ever come to a place where we're not experiencing that transformation, we're not experiencing that intimacy with Him, it's a time to really cry out to God and ask Him to do something deeper in our lives. Even as we consider the epistle that John wrote and the book of Revelation, there he points out and he talks about the fact that God assesses the passion of the churches to the church of Ephesus in Revelation 2:4. Now God says that you have lost your first love. We may be filled with godly activities, but we may have really lost that closeness of heart with God. And similarly to the church of Laodicea in Revelation 3 verse 15, now God says that the church had become lukewarm, and he would have wanted the church to either be hot or cold, meaning to be passionate. However, because the church was lukewarm, you know, God warned the church and said that I am even ready to spit you out. So we understand here that even God is in search of a passionate relationship, and he does not want our relationship with him to just be an obligation or just be something that we're not excited about spiritually. So today I just want to encourage us, you know, to have this healthy, vibrant relationship with God and do whatever it takes. You know, maybe for some of us, we just need to spend more time in prayer. For some of us, we may want to spend more time in God's Word to refresh us, nurture us. We may want to step out and do something for the Lord that He's putting on our hearts. Whatever it is, no, take that step to go closer to God, because God loves a passionate pursuit. And let's pray and cry out to God to remove every dullness and revive our hearts towards Him once again. Let's pray together. Heavenly Father, we come before You. Father, we pray that, Lord, You would minister to our hearts, O God. And Father, that every phase, O God, of this journey with You, that, Lord, You will cause us to come deeper, that, Lord, You will cause us, Lord, to pursue You more passionately, Father God. Lord, we pray that You will give us that grace, Lord, to keep becoming stronger with You. Lord, we thank You that, Lord, You are speaking to our hearts. We thank You that You are strengthening us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.